Hi everyone, and welcome back to another video. So today I'm going to be reacting to Bring Me the Horizon's new song, Die For You. I'm really excited about this, and I really waited for you guys because the song came out yesterday. And yesterday was Yom Kippur. For those of you who don't know, I live in Israel, and it's really disrespectful to listen to loud music on Yom Kippur because people are fasting and it's just a time to just say sorry for everything that you did wrong to people that are important to you, and just come clean for the new year. And so it's really disrespectful to listen to loud music. So I waited for today. I haven't listened to the song yet, and I'm so excited. Like, honestly, just like, I really can't wait. I just want you guys to know that there is a reason that I didn't film the video yesterday and posted yesterday, because respect the people around you. So I am so excited for this, and let's get right into it because I can't wait. Okay, so Bring Me the Horizon, Die For You. Let's get right into it. I have the music video in front of me. The lyrics in the description. If you want to see the music video, go watch it, and come back to here to see my reaction if you haven't listened to the song yet, because I'm sure it's great. So let's get right into it in 3, 2, 1. I'm really excited. The music video looks so good already. Production value, yes. The production is high.
Business.
Okay, people are talking. I don't know. I'm too excited for this. Okay, I recognize this as the new symbol. Oh, that looks so good. You know that I died for, I cried for, you know that I died for you. You know that I grieve for, I grieve for, you know that I grieve for you. Already stopping. Oh my god, those vocals! He's singing in a mixed voice, he isn't singing in a chest voice. For those of you who don't know, a mixed voice is between your head voice and your chest voice, and sometimes it's really hard to find your mixed voice. That's why you go to a vocal coach. But this sounds so good. So I listened to their whole discography before this, after the part 2 video, and like, I recognize that Ollie usually sings in a chest voice because he screams a lot, and it's really more of a rock sound and metal sound to sing in a chest voice. But I love that he's singing here in a mixed voice. It sounds so good already, guys. Like, yeah, let's just continue. Okay, drop. I recognize the build-up. That scream, yes. Nice. Okay, so obviously they used like electronics and in the mixing and the production stuff. When they recorded this, they did the they did that on the computer and stuff, but you can actually do that live, like you heard me do that. It's a form of a vibrato, which just takes some practice, but this sounds really good. Guys, this sounds so good, like, yes. I love the vocals. I'm vibing. I love the guitars, the bass, the drums, they're so good. Oh wait, that sounded actually so good. Let's listen to that run again, because that was beautiful. He switched there to a chest voice to reach those lower notes. That's so cool. It did that really smoothly. Usually, if you want to do that, what you need to do is just raise your soft palate and just breathe through it. Let the air continue flowing, and it will just be a smooth transition. It takes some practice, but it sounds really cool. And it did that so smoothly. Also, like, is like, you know, that I die for. The die for is an F sharp, which I don't know if it's on the male range like that, but for female range, that is where you would start moving to your mixed voice and your head voice. So yeah, that's really cool. I'm just in love with this song already, you guys. Like, okay, so he's singing and they're screaming in the background. Okay, so after I listened to the chorus a few times, I think what he's doing there, he's like, you know that I die for, I cry for, is on the high notes, is going to the mixed voice, and on the rest is kind of like in between, but his vocals are super clean, and just everything like super clean, and the transitions are running so smoothly, you would actually think he's singing in a mixed voice the whole time, like, you know that I die for, I cry for. Sorry guys, I didn't do a vocal warm-up. But actually what he does is he uses his chest voice and then moves up to a mixed voice on the high notes, which is a really nice technique that he's doing, and it really helps the voice because you're not straining it too much. Which is a very cool technique you should do. Also, the music video is really cool. Those harmonies there were really cool. Okay, stop. That's a really creepy smile. And now I'm getting safe rock and roll vibes, like the music video from Fall Out Boy, like the end. If you've seen it, you know what I mean. Okay. This isn't love. This is a bloodbath. This isn't love. It is. This is a sentence. It's a broken hand. By the way, lyrics up here. Nice, just cutting all the instruments out and just his vocals, but it's a scream in the background. That was just so nice. Oh my god, this song was so good. Like, I'm going to listen to it again so many times. Like, oh my god, that was incredible. The only thing I'm worried about was when Ollie screamed, it sounded like it really came from his throat, which is really bad for your vocal cords, because it just shows that you're straining and you're not in the right placement, and then you can really damage them. But other than that, like, it wasn't even in all the screams, just at the end, which I really hope didn't strain them too much, because his screaming is really good. But I love the vocals, I love the drums, I love the guitar, I love the bass, I love all the electronics and stuff. The production was amazing, the music video was amazing. Guys, this song would be really cool to see live, and I have hope. Because, as I said, like, I live in Israel and, you know, bands don't come here. But the Bring Me the Horizon actually did come here a decade ago. It was a decade ago, like in 2011. But, you know, a girl can have hopes. So this would be really cool to see live, because this is such a bop. Like, honestly, guys, like, tell me that you listen to this and you think this is a good song. This isn't a good song, or this isn't a bop. I dare you. And if you do, you're lying, because this was incredible. It was amazing. It goes on my top 5 songs by them so far. And this was so good. I'm going to listen to this all the time. All day, every day. Maybe I'll even, like, I'm back to vocal lessons. I took a break for a month, so I'll probably work on this song with my vocal coach, because this song is really good. And it sounds so fun to sing and just vibe to. And yeah, like, I don't know what else to say. This was amazing. This was incredible. I loved it so much. And yeah, like, I don't have anything else to say. This was just an amazing song. And also the lyrics were incredible. Didn't even talk about the lyrics. They're so sweet, but also so sad, and I'm just like, I want to give all of them a hug. And I want to give, like, and Ollie sound, like, there were so many emotions in his vocals that I really want to give him a hug. But this was so beautiful. Like, honestly, this song is amazing. So yeah, let's wrap this up, because I can just continue to talk about how amazing this song for hours. So yeah, if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you do subscribe, please click the notification bell because I do try and post every week. I'll leave links to my social medias down below. I have a Snapchat now, guys, so you can go and follow me there. I also have an Instagram and a Twitter, so you can also follow me there if you want. And yeah, also I just wanted to say all of you in the comments were so sweet on my few latest videos, and just want to say thank you so much, because you guys are so sweet. And I just noticed that we went over 360 subscribers. We hit 300 last week, guys. Like, it just makes me so happy that you guys are enjoying the videos and stuff, and you know, just it makes me so happy. So I just want to say thank you. And yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!